guys, it's me, Mitch, doing another LEGO Star Wars review. This is on a summer 2012 set. This is set 9525, pre-Vizsla's Mandalorian Fighter. It's ages 8 to 14, has 403 pieces, and retails for $49.99 US. So on the front of your box here, you've got the 2012 Darth Maul logo. The info for the set, the three minifigs down the side, includes one new and hard-to-find minifigure. I think it's pretty obvious who that is. And a nice picture of the set. By the way, this set is only available at the LEGO store and Walmart. And on the top of the box, you've got your minifigs in actual size. And on the back, you've got an advertisement for LEGO.com. And all the play features and a few little action scenes for the set. So, this is a pretty big box, guys. Compared to some sets of the same price or the approximate same piece count. And I'm just getting out my knife here really quick. There we are. I just fold that back up. Okay, guys, here we go. Just dump out the pieces. Yay, numbered bags. That's good. So let's just remove these bags out of the way for a second. We have one sticker sheet with 9 sticker, wait. Okay, 10 stickers, my bad. So not too bad there. Just gonna give you a bit of a focus on that. And why is it not focusing? There we go. So then we have one instruction manual here. Let's see, is anything interesting at the back? No, it just transfers into book 2 at page 47. So we open up book 2 and it starts, and then we move right along here. It gives you your pieces in your parts inventory for the set. And the rest of the parts inventory for the set, and more about the play features, a picture of all the summer sets from 2012, and the minifigs, and when. So, what else do we got besides the stickers and instructions? We have bag 1, bag 2, we have bag 3, and we have bag 4. So, I've got some building to do here. I'm actually going to move the box out of the way while I'm building. Let's get to building this. So, here we have the completed set. So, I'm just gonna grab my pick-a-brick cup here, open it up, and we'll take a look at our extra pieces. We have a bunch of Technic pins, a couple cheese slopes, a clip, and a couple one-by-one round plates. So, there are the extra pieces. Now onto the minifigures. So the first minifigure in the set is Obi-Wan Kenobi. Now this is not his season 3, 4, 5 outfit. This is his season 1 and 2 outfit for the Clone Wars. And well, the first like 9 episodes of season 3. But he has come in a few other sets. Not really much to say. Blue lightsaber. Yeah. There is Obi-Wan Kenobi. The second minifigure, which is slightly less common than Obi-Wan, is the Mandalorian soldier, Deathwatch soldier, or whatever. He has just the same, he's the exact same as the one in the Mandalorian battle pack, with this face, which is the exact same as the one from the Mandalorian battle pack. Now on to the one and only exclusive figure for this set. The third and final, and the only exclusive minifigure in the set is Pre Vizsla. First of all, you can see he does come with the darksaber. Very nice that LEGO finally made one. He comes with this extremely awesome cape. Pauldron, my bad. With a Death Watch symbol on it of sorts. He has a gunmetal jetpack as opposed to the dark gray one on the trooper. He does have some nice front torso printing there with some blue and his belt, some yellow stripes there and Mandalorian armor. And then he has some more leg printing as well, which is very nice. And he has this blonde hairpiece, which is the same as the Chancellor Palpatine from Palpatine's Arrest, and also the Chancellor, the Clone Wars Chancellor Palpatine from the, Venator. Hold on, let me just blow my nose really quick. Okay. Whoops. Oh, jeez. Yeah, as you can see, he's got a pretty generic, looking face. I mean, it's unique, but a completely exclusive face print, but it could be used for other things, I'm sure. So, yeah, he does have this awesome helmet, and I'm just gonna put that on him and give you a look. And here we have Pre Vizsla with his helmet, looking very awesome. So, there are your minifigures. So, here we have the Mandalorian Starfighter itself, guys. Very big, as you can see. Very tall. Definitely looks like a lot more than 403 pieces. Looks like 600 pieces or something. Very big. Now I can see why they made it 403 pieces for $50. But anyways, it does have these guns at the front which can move, although that's not really, they're just supposed to, they're meant to stay like this. So that, there's that. It does have some landing gear here. And the ship is in landing mode right now. Can fold up the landing gear like that, and the foot just wraps around the front like so. And then the wings, you can, they're on click hinges, and you can just go like that and fold them down. Very nice design. I'm just gonna give you a quick overview. Hold on. Why does that always fall off? Quick rundown of the stickers, guys, before I show you a bit of what I would consider a design flaw on this set. There is a sticker right here on this part. There's a sticker right here and right here. Sticker here, sticker there. Sticker there, which the cockpit can rotate, by the way. Sticker there and sticker there. And a stickered control panel inside the cockpit, which we'll take a look at right now. It's got these pieces, which I believe were first introduced in Friends,
those like little seating pieces. So you can do. Just take Previsla and your Deathwatch Trooper and put them inside. It's kind of hard to put Previsla in there without wrinkling his cape a tiny bit, but it's a flexible material anyway, so not a big deal. And say Previsla should be driving it, so like being the main person in charge of flying it and stuff, I guess you can do it that way. So wait, why isn't the cockpit closing? Hold on. I thought it was supposed to... Oh, Previsla was not in the right place. There. Hold on, this is not as easy as putting figures in some cockpits. There we go, check that out, that's cool. Then, in terms of their weapons, the pistol and the darksaber. Pistol for the trooper and darksaber for Previsla. Where'd that go? There's, as you can see, really quick, these guns right here on the back are fragile. I think they're supposed to be built like that. Hold on, let me take a look at the box real quick. Yep, that is how they're supposed to be built. Although, they are pretty fragile, so you really want to push them on. Push these cone pieces on as hard as you can, and even when you do, you know what, maybe these agents guns are on wrong. Hold on a second, guys. Okay, guys, so I do have these built correctly. It's just they're a bit loose at times, but anyway, they can spin around 360 degrees, the whole attachment, and they can swivel up and down, which then the way I was doing it just now made the cone piece come loose and it's sticking to my finger or something. So, bear with me, guys. I do not really like the design of these back guns here. I think they should have found a better piece or maybe just made, like, an entirely new piece for that. Although, that might be a waste of a new piece mold. But anyways, there is a little hidden compartment, I guess you could say, right here. There's this hole right here, which you can just slide the darksaber into, like so. And if you come down to the bottom here, this piece, you know what, I'm just going to angle the camera up a bit. This white piece right here can fold down, and out comes the box. And this box is the same one as in the Bounty Hunter Assault Gunship from 2011. You know what, guys, hold on, let me angle light a little more over here. There we go. There it is. And you can just take the pistol. And by the way, this piece is printed. This tile has the details on that are printed. And then you can open this back up and put the box back in. So basically, to get the box in, you open this. To get the box out, you open the bottom. Now, a lot of times in the Clone Wars, you see them flying like this, like the Mandalorian fighters flying like this, but, it can't, but, you do sometimes, I'm pretty sure, see it flying like this. They can fly like this, I think, so, that's how LEGO wants you to do it, and I'm failing to keep those guns at the back together. I don't like those guns, to be honest. And everything can rotate a full 360 degrees. The cockpit, the wings, which it looks cooler when the wings are rotating, but your hand kind of gets in the way. No matter how big or small it is, I would say. Let's see, did I miss something? I feel like I missed something. Oh, right. There are engines back here that look like that. Thrusters. And, yeah, there is the awesome Mandalorian fighter. So overall, guys, this is just a really amazing set. Now, when you look at the price per piece initially, 403 pieces for $49.99, $50, it seems like it's not going to be a good value. But once you have the thing built,
it's just way, it's bigger than you'd expect. It definitely looks bigger than a 403 piece set. It looks more like a bigger set. In terms of the minifigures, this one, this is the first time they've made him since, like, 2011 in a set, so he's not as common as he used to be, but, yeah, he's still relatively common overall in the, over the past few years. This Mandalorian warrior, trooper, soldier, whatever, is, it's great, you can never have enough of these figures, unless you bought, like, 5,000 of the battle packs, which I don't think anyone did, because that would come out to about, $65,000 worth of battle packs. Anyway, and then Previous Law is exclusive, and he's kind of essential for Mandalorian stuff. So, there is Previous Law's Mandalorian Starfighter. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and stay tuned for more Star Wars weekend, because it's not Star Wars Day anymore, because I ran out of time yesterday, reviews. So, yeah. Bye, guys.